Welcome to First Play. Today we're trying out 8-Bit Boy. I already recorded this one, but for some reason the game audio didn't get recorded. So I'm gonna record this again, and I'm gonna start a new game. I will be uploading the first recording also, but I will probably use YouTube's, you know, music thing to add music to the background. Or I'll go look up some free sample music to put in for background music. And I'm gonna play through it again now. This video is not gonna be as long as the first one, because I've already, like I said, I've already played through this. I made it to World 3. And now I'm just gonna start a new one over it. Normal. Okay, if you, there's gonna be a bunch of text coming up, and if you wanna read it, just pause and read it. I'm not gonna read it out. There's like four walls of text. I'm not gonna read all that. Son of a... Matter of fact, I'll probably put this at the beginning and make it one long episode, and I will just, like, the part without music, I'll make it fast-forwarded. That way it'll cut the size of the video down a lot. I do like the effects on here. That's a pretty cool effect right there. That's pretty cool also. I'm glad they didn't do white on black. That would have been a little too bright. The light blue is perfect. Alright, let's go play through the tutorial again. Oh boy. Yeah, I just want to give you a feel of what the game's music is like, because the game's music is awesome. Without it, it just doesn't feel the same. Oh yeah, there's a plus box here. Ding. And the shields basically act like the mushrooms from Mario, except for no shrinkage or growing involved. And if you don't watch the portion after this without the game music, I don't blame you. These grapes, they look like grapes to me. This would be a good opportunity, because on the other one I found a warp tunnel. It took me to World 2, 7. And this time, I think, depending on how long I make the video, I will play through the whole first world. I will skip that warp tunnel. The warp tube, if you don't watch the video after this, it looks like one of them storage things from Mega Man X that would hold your power-ups that Dr. Light would give you. Seriously, why am I falling so hard at jumping right now? Yay, World 1, finally! Gotcha, birdie. I pretty much know where all the secrets are at the beginning of this game, because this is the second time through. See. But it was amazing the first time I found it. if you want my genuine reaction, you should definitely watch the second half of this video. Anytime I say something, I'll probably slow the video down so you can hear what I say, and then speed back up. Especially the parts where I die over and over and over again, I'm definitely gonna speed them up. Cause I think in World 2-9, I died like, oh man, I died so many times. Luckily the game has a reload system. It doesn't make you start over at the beginning of the world, you just reload at the beginning of the level and with all whatever you had when you beat the last level. So if you had a whole bunch of lives when you beat the last level, when you go into the next level and say you die and get a game over, you'll reload with all the stuff you had from the last level, which is pretty awesome. Definitely would have been a nice feature on, say, Mega Man. Yes, the Black Bear shooting fireballs. It also would have been a nice feature on Mario. You don't really get power-ups. Well, yeah, you do. You get shields and stuff in Sonic. Sonic 2, I think, the only one you really got was the ring, the electric shield that brought the rings to you. I think Sonic and Knuckles, the cartridge, added more power-ups, if I remember right. Can't get away, Birdie Bird. Yeah, this game feels a lot like Super Mario World. Even the level design looks similar. And then some of the aspects, like all the hidden things, reminds me of Sonic 2 from the Genesis. Okay, there is a secret right here that brings you up through here. To get to it, you go down here, you just fall down. Boom. You walk right through here and you got it. Okay, I got a red berry down there in storage. To use that, I'm using the Xbox 360 controller. I know I'm just repeating stuff that you'll probably hear in the second part of the video if you watch it, but if you don't want to watch it, that's fine too. That's why I'm repeating this stuff. That little thing down in the bottom, I'm playing with the 360 controller, so the Y button activates that. And that was a feature in Mario 3 on the NES, if I remember right, where you could get like an extra leaf or an extra, what was the tail called? I want to say raccoon, but I don't think that's right. Might have been a raccoon tail that let you fly. And in Super Mario World, it was a feather, and that was stored in the top. And so basically, that's that feature. Wow, this is a lot easier than the second time through. First time I died like 2 or 3 times, I think. And the plus coins are special things hidden throughout the world. There's 50 of them, like you can see on the screen. I think I had 2 or 3 in the first playthrough. So. Doink. Oh, I missed it. Doink. This should be an extra life. Oh, it's 50 coins. Okay. The power-ups, they give them to you in a certain order most of the time. That I can tell. You always get the shield power-up first if you don't already have it. Oh, shit. Then you get the... hey, why didn't you run off the level? Like they do in Mario. Okay, where was I? You get the shield power-up, then you get the green grape power-up, and yes, I'm calling them grapes. This is where the warp is, so I'm gonna avoid that. Because I do not want to go... I want to see what the rest of the levels are like. You get the red power-up, just like I got now. Oh, I should have used the one I had down in storage. Because then I could have got a green one. Then they give you a green power-up. The red power-up is just one grape. Green power-up is 2 grapes that are faster. And then you get the black grapes that are on fire, and they're faster than the green grapes too. So it's overall, it's a better power. And then after that, sometimes you get an extra life. Sometimes you get 50 coins. Oh no, this is where the warp is. Okay, now I'm going back. My power up just got changed. Because I hit 100 coins again. Oh, son of a... Oh no, I used my shield by accident. Damn. Oh wow. Well, at least the baddies don't respawn when you scroll to the right like they did in the old Super Nintendo games. And the old NES games. Alright, got another shield. And like I explained before, the shields work just like the mushrooms. They give you one extra hit. So you don't die from the first hit instantly. Which is great. Okay. Take that, birdie. This birdie jumps, right? Okay, anything hidden here? No. Darn. Oh, well, I'm at the end of the level. Don't tell me to hurry up. Jeez. This game is pretty fun, though. Wow. Oh, no. Oh, no. The water. I hate the water ones. If you don't watch my thing in the, if you don't watch the second half of this, and I think, I want to say World 2-8, there's a level where the water rises. It feels a lot like the chemical level from Sonic 2, where the water's rising and you can easily drown. But on this one, you don't drown. If you touch the water, you die instantly. Look. Boom. I guess your character can't swim or something, so he just dematerializes. It's like, what the flip, man? Oh, there's some blocks up here I can smash. Come on. Oh, there's a secret here! Heck yes! Alright. Oh, I got hit by a piranha. Those piranhas remind me of the jumping mechanical fish from Sonic 1. I think it's the Green Hill Zone? Where they're jumping like that. They're under a bridge, and there's a waterfall, if I remember right. Man, it's been a long time since I've played the original Sonic games. I just got them all recently on Humble Bundle. They had basically the whole Sonic collection for $10. And if you buy the Sonic collection on sale on Steam, it'll cost you $50. Now, if you buy it when it's not on sale, it retails for, I think, $150 or $200? It's really expensive. So to be able to get it for $10 was a steal. And it has, well, basically every Sonic game. So when I got it, the first thing I did was install Sonic Adventure DX version. And it's basically just a port of the, Sonic Adventure DX, but the screen resolution is horrible. I need to pay attention. Quit talking. The screen resolution is horrible. It's like 4x3, so it's the old tube television resolution. They didn't update it for widescreen TVs or widescreen monitors, for that fact, which I do have, because my monitor is like, I think it's 32 inch, but it's a widescreen 32 inch. You know, so it's 16x9. Ooh, there's a power up here. How did I miss that last time? So it's 16x9, not 4x3. So when you're playing it, it's got, you know, this black, I think they actually filled it in on the sides with like something else. But it looks horrible. So the first thing I did is I went and looked on the discussion forums, and there's actually a mod pack that you can install that will fix the resolution. Not only does it fix the resolution, but it has a bunch of other stuff, like little hacky things. Oh, see? Bunch of little hacky things to make the game better. I can't remember what they all are, but one of them is better controller support. Oh, one of them is better controller support, so I installed that so I can play with my Xbox controller. There was the widescreen fix, which lets you go all the way up to my max screen resolution, which is like 2,500 something by 1,000 something. And then, because NVIDIA card has, super resolution stretch mode or something like that. I can't remember the exact name, but it gives you a huge resolution. And then it shrinks that resolution down to your monitor size. So you get better picture quality by compressing those pixels. And it does work. It works really well. I give them props to that. It works really well. It makes some games look that would normally look like garbage on a huge resolution. It stretches them out and then compresses them. So you don't get the compression, the stretch artifacts through the compression. It's actually pretty genius. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, look, another secret. Oh, I guess normally you would jump down this way and find it and skip all that stuff and just come on down. Okay, well, that's good to know if I ever play through this level again. Hopefully I won't be. I'm hoping this is my last time through this level. There's too many water traps. But I guess I'm in a sewer or something, because look at all them pipes. But who puts piranhas in the sewer? Seriously? I mean, that's what they look like, piranhas. They also look like, I already mentioned it, but they look like those red mechanical piranhas from Sonic 2. These things, I don't think I've ever seen a game with something like that in them. Oh, I know what they remind me of. The piranha, the man-eating plants that come out of the tubes in Super Mario World on Super Nintendo. Okay, I got another plus coin. That's cool. Wonder how long it'll take me to make it to the... Oh, I'm cutting this part out. Wonder how long it'll take me to make it to the boss. I might end up having a 40-minute video followed by a 20-minute video that's been sped up. Oh, I lost my powers! How dare you! Take that, birdie. Okay, I got a shield, which is the first thing you always get. Take that, and you can't come back up here, man, 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 man. Oh, that killed him. I didn't know that you could do that. This is my second time through, and I've never killed a bad guy by hitting him like that. I don't know why I didn't think about that. You can do that in Super Mario. I think the third one, you can hit blocks and it bumps the bad guys up. I don't know why I'm telling y'all this. I know y'all, if you're watching this, you've definitely played Super Mario. At least one of them. And I mean, the mechanics from the Mario games are pretty much the same for every game. They just get more and more improved. Basically, Mario hasn't changed since the... Since the third game, I mean, all the mechanics are pretty much the same. Man, I need to quit messing around. I've only got 80 seconds left to get through this level. Oh, at the end is coming up anyways. You can always tell because they start putting signs normally. Is there a secret here? Yes! Man, the secrets in this game are just too obvious. Oh great, now I'm gonna get another okay, I'm dead. I'm not gonna get another shield. I was gonna say, oh great, I'm gonna get another shield. shield here. Boom. Let's go back and get the spring. Doink. Okay, I got them all but one. That's good enough for me. Take that, flappy birds. That's what they look like. Oh man, I hope I'm not gonna get a strike against this video for mentioning Flappy Bird. That would really piss me off. It don't matter because I don't have ads on the videos anymore anyways. I don't make any revenue from YouTube. I do this as a hobby. I mainly started this to learn how to do video editing. And I found out I enjoy doing it. Which is weird. But I've always enjoyed doing... what do you call it? Enjoy doing tasks like that, like editing, and it's one of the main reasons why I enjoy making mods for the Bethesda games. Because using their editor can be a little tedious, but I don't mind it. Come back here, Snakey. I need to jump on you. Oh, are you effing kidding me? Oh, I had a blackberry down there. Why wasn't I using that? God, I probably got the most deaths in this game. I wouldn't be surprised. Whee! Alright, green berry. Green grapes! Get your green grapes! Got some grapes for you, birdies! Boom. I wonder where the designer chose these as the power-up. Was it just a pay homage to Super Mario? Because they use a mushroom and... Oh! A hidden block. That is so totally, what's that Extreme Mario thing called? Oh, another green grape. Wow. It's better than red. Boom. I can't think of the name of it. But if you want to look it up, there are some Extreme Mario levels that were made, you know, before Super Mario Maker came out. And, they're basically like challenge levels. And you gotta be really good to beat those. I think I'm gonna go ahead and use my red grape. Sorry about that, I got a text from my mom. Okay, onward. Yay, I beat the level. I can't believe I died right at the end of the level last time. That's so stupid. I should have saved my grapes. Okay, well, I got a whole nother day to do recording. Because mom's not coming back till tomorrow. So, yay, no screaming. I wonder if I can go down. I don't want to risk. Well, yeah, let's do it. Okay, I'm glad I didn't jump down back there. Is there a secret here? Come on, come on. Yes! And the secrets are a little too obvious in this game. Or maybe I've just played too many games like this growing up. I bet that's what it is. Man, I was hoping for a vine. I want to climb up there. I just about bet there's a secret up there. Ooh, a bat? A new enemy. Cool. How do I get to this? That's another secret. Boom. Got you, floppy thing. I wonder if the creator has names for all these creatures. I think he does. I know when I design stuff, I love to give stuff names. It's also the hardest part of the process, coming up with names for stuff. Secret? Secret? Yes! What did I get? Extra life? I don't know, I didn't see what I got. Oh! Let's break these. I have Mario Syndrome. I must break every block I see! Haha, got you, Batty Bat. Batty the Batty Bat. Okay, what's down here? Coinage. Ooh. Well, at least they didn't use rings. What else game uses coins? Mario does, doesn't it? I'm pretty sure Mario uses coins. And they also have, if you're playing Super Mario World, it has the special Yoshi coins that you gotta collect. And then here it's plus coins. I bet the creator would be mad that I'm comparing this to Super Mario World Mega games. Or maybe not, I don't know. I mean, this creation is, you know, supposed to remind people of those type of games. At least that's what I took from that intro statement. Oh no no no! Ah, I missed the damn jump. I don't think I will make it to the boss in under 40 minutes. But I will try. I'm a damnest. I need to speed things up here if I want to make it in time. Quit looking for secrets. I'm trying to get to the boss. I want to see if the boss is another bird. No! 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 Okay, I got in too much of a hurry. No, no, son of a... Okay, some of my deaths might be sped up on this. It'd be nice if I can keep the whole video, including part 2, under 40 minutes. Not to mention, I might have two separate audio files to edit. That's not gonna be fun. Then I gotta mash them together, and then speed the whole thing up. Okay. Get rid of Birdie here. So I get coins. Is that bat following me? I think that bat is following me. Oh, why the hell did I do that? Oh my god. Hit left for some reason when I hit the platform and just right into the water. Boy, I'm glad that this game has a reset system. Oh man, if it was like what was it, Mario 3, I think, if you died you had to start. We started over at the beginning of the level, but you didn't have your powers or your you didn't have your powers. Unless you have one in storage. Good thing about that game, though, is you could get extra stuff, and then you can also buy powers, like leaves and feathers. I think that's the one with the frog suit. The one with the frog suit, the Kanuki suit, which is the raccoon thing. What else did I have? God, it's been so long since I've played it. I need to reinstall my NES emulator. I have the Genesis emulator that's Sega actually put out on Steam. I really like it. I have a problem with it though, the resolution. You can't change the resolution, so it's stuck on the maximum resolution. I actually need to change it to a resolution below it. I can't figure out how. It just won't let me change it. Oh, finally, the end of the level. Because when you click on the arrow to change the resolution, it just doesn't do anything. It's weird. Wow. Look at all them points. World 1 set. More water. Oh, you can't. Okay. I thought you could jump on that thing, but you can't. That's background. And the levels are definitely getting harder in design. Ooh, there's something up there. Is there a hidden block here? Nope. Is there a secret here? Yes! I can tell the guy, or the person, I don't know if it's a guy, could be a woman for all I know, who designed this loves her secret passages. Seriously? How the bleep? Oh. Oh, what? Oh, man. The controls in this game, they're okay, but I'm playing with the 360 control. I should be playing with the D-pad, but I'm playing with the analog. And so it's a little... My analog's a little slidey, you could say. Now, if I was playing with the D-pad, I don't think it would do that. Yeah, the D-pad is a lot... It's a lot smoother. The analog has some bounce back when you let go of the control, when you let go of the analog, when it bounces back to center. But I haven't played with the D-pad in so long, I don't think I can do it. Now when you're playing like Street Fighter, even the new Street Fighters, it's really hard to play with the analog stick. I've tried, I just can't do it. It's so much easier to do specials, and especially because I'm a Ryu player. I love playing the game as Ryu. Go down. Why go down? There's a bouncy thing. Ooh, another plus coin. Oh, son of, go down and get back to the level. Is what it was. Okay, so that stuff I saw above me earlier, I know what it is now. Man, I wish there was a way you could jump on them product thing and kill them. But you can't, because that eats you up. Okay, secret here. Kill the bug. No, what the flip? I was on that sucker. By the way, I am not this bad at Mario. Not nearly. This game, I would say it's I wouldn't say it's harder than Mario. It's, the level design is definitely harder than Mario. That's for sure. I'm only in World 1. Some of these levels feel like the end of some of the Mario games. I mean, look at them little tiny platforms to stand on. Okay, I gotta bump this, get the spring. Doink! Is there a secret here? Yeah! I went left last time. I'm not doing that this time. Ooh, no, water. No, not worth it. Not worth it. Haha! Is this the way I'm supposed to be going? Guess not, because I don't see no way of getting up there unless I am just, you know, being stupid. Okay, so evidently I am supposed to go this way. And the music for this game is awesome. Yeah, the second half is gonna really suck about the game music. Flip! How did I miss that? I kind of I guess I jumped too early. Man, you know what this game needs? Is halfway checkpoints. Like Super Mario World has. Gimme. Time to die, fishy fish. Fishy fish, you're going down. Gotcha. Eight-bit man, killing all the fish and birds. I wonder if 8-bit man actually has a name. I'm sure he does, I didn't read the intro stuff. Because there was too much. That's like going on a forum and asking a question and then somebody like gives you a 3-page reply. You're like, dude, all you had to do is like tell me how to do it. I didn't need all that information, jeez. See, how come the green birds walk off of things, but like the blue ones don't? Are they just design? Was that a design choice or what? Get me with a black bird, I'll show you how we're there. Boom. Boom. Turkeys! No. That's where I was last time. Ooh, end of the level. Gotcha. Ooh, there's a power up at the end of the level, nice. Green grapes! I guess you're saying you're gonna need them in here. 1-8. It's only got two more levels to the boss. If it's like World 2, where you get to the boss on the 10th stage. Ooh, blackberry. Alright, got both of them. Boom, 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 boom. I'm glad these things are infinite. Because if they were like, you only get like 100 or 10 or something like that. Sorry, can I get up there? Don't look like it because they bounce off. And I found out if you watch the second part, I found out that shoot the bullets into a wall, and if there's a secret area there, the bullets will go right through. Ooh, more time. That's cool. I didn't know that was even a thing. I wonder if this is an extra long level. Bird. Just a, better not. Ooh, teleport. Level with teleports, huh? Haha! See, look. You can shoot your fireball or whatever you got right into the secret passage. I tell you right now, that was not timing. That was pure luck. So, Oh, great. Springs and water. If it was just springs, it wouldn't be a big deal. You know, spring a big empty space. You gotta throw the water in there. What'd I get? A life? I thought it was a life. Man, I got a life! Can't do video games anymore. That would suck. Especially when you got stuff like Witcher 3 and Fallout 4. Man, I'd hate to have to stop playing video games. When I was in the hospital, it was horrible. I couldn't play no video games. Mainly because, you know, my hand didn't work, so didn't really have much choice. Alright, 1-9. Make it to this next level and we should make it to the boss. And when we make it to the boss, it'll probably be the end. If it's another bird, like the second boss, I'm probably just gonna skip it and it'll be the end of the video. It says jump down. I don't know about that. Okay, you don't have an option. You can't clear that gap. What's this? Secret. Yeah, give me a power up. Too bad you can't walk through there. That'd be nice. I wonder what this game was built on. Was it built on a custom engine? I bet it was. Oh, shh. I mean, technically, you can build something like this in RPG Maker. If you, you had to restrict one of the axes, I can't remember which one it is, but then your character only walks sideways. And then you just build the maps to look like a side scroller instead of an overhead map, and then you got your levels. Matter of fact, RPG Maker might be one of the best things to build something like this in. Especially if you can afford a new one, Ace. I think it's Ace. I have it on Steam, and I wouldn't mind making a game, but I want to make something like Earthbound. Something wacky, you know, and off the wall. New high score. Reload. Give me blackberries! Yes! Gotcha. Take that stupid Flappy Bird. That is definitely the best power up. Power up makes me feel like Mega Man running around blasting the metal robots. I thought that was a coin block. Are you effing kidding me? I press jump and he just walks right into the water. Oh, that's aggravating. Oh, I guess I should get the shield, huh? What? It didn't spring. There we go. Bye bye, Mr. Snake. Wonder how you're getting that secret. What the f- Boy just looks so happy to be here. Flip! Are you kidding me? He killed me because he jumped into me even though I had jumped on his head? Is that what happened? I don't understand. Be a good game to try to speed run. But it'd be hard. Yes, boss. Get me out of here before that bird comes back. Hurry up. There we go. Ugh, it's walking me to the boss automatically again. I know how to use a controller game. Jeez. Okay, it is a bird again, it's just a green one. What the flip? Flippity flip flip. And of course, I've only got one life again. This happened last time, too. On the second world boss, which is gonna be in the other video. Okay. Well, I already beat one boss. I beat level world 2's boss, so I'm not even gonna try to beat this one. This is gonna be the end of the video. Okay, from what I've played, I really do enjoy this game. I love that it has a reload system that once you lose all your lives, you don't lose all your progress, which is... That was really annoying about them old school games. If you like platformer games, you should definitely pick this up. It's a pretty good game. Hope to see you in the next video.